Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to quickly go over how to match one column's values to another column and how to do multiple columns to multiple columns. So in the first one, we're just going to type equals match. If you type in the first couple letters, it will show up. You can double click. So the lookup value will be this value. And then if we put a comma and just drag down in this column the values that we want to look up to see if they match this number. We put another column, we can do exact match, and it will equal one because it will be the first value in this array that we chose. So if we drag this down, it's not going to work because it will drag down both values, so we're going to want to delete these. And we can just put dollar signs. The pretty quick way to do it is just type in front of the E, in front of the 2, and then in front of the E, in front of the 16. That will make these absolute values, so when we drag this down, this value will also move, but this value will stay the same. So if we drag this down, we can see that in this row, these columns do not match. And also in this row, these columns do not match. So that's a quick match tool. And so say you have a ton of data, what you can do is create a header here and then go into the data tab. If you're in the home tab, just go to data, click filter, and then you can look up unselect all and only look up the NAs, not applicables, where it shows that the values do not match. So if we hit Control Z, we'll undo that. And how to compare multiple columns, we're gonna wanna type equals and. We can double click that. And it will just compare logical statements. So we could do this is equal to this value is the first thing we want to check, and if we put a comma, we can do this value also equals this value. And so it'll come back with a Boolean, which means it will either come back with true or false. And we don't need to make any absolute because it will just compare right down the line as we drag down the formula. You can add more than two statements, but for this example, we only have two statements. And there is false here because these don't both match. There's another false here. And say we change one of these values to not match, change this to 50, this will now be false. So one way to look up if they're false, we could put true, false, and then do the same thing where we just filter. And then we can look up the false values, which will show. And if you want it to be more visual, we can use conditional formatting. So we go back to home, conditional formatting, highlight cells. We could do text that contains. We could do false. And as you can see from the preview, this will highlight all the values that came back with false, with light red fill in a dark red text, so you can easily see which ones do not match. And that's all I have for you today. Please like, subscribe, and comment, and thanks for watching.